Hello gamers and welcome back to the Armbar Arcade in a slightly different UFC 2 career mode episode. So far we've taken Jimmy Lights Out Rogers on a welterweight run which included a 12 fight win streak at its peak. With a few losses on the way, we weren't really struggling at all until the game decided to put legitimate title contenders down into the 20s and 30s of the rankings just to end our win streak. We fought Tyron Woodley and Damian Maia far earlier than we really should have and actually managed to win one of those. However, it's tough not to feel like the game is really stepping it up now with tons of highly rated fighters and famous names blocking our way through the 20s of the rankings and stopping this series from having the championship climax it deserves. So for this episode, I've recorded an hour's worth of fights, which ended up as 9. Our record before this episode stood at 16-4, and I'm going to talk about what I've liked and disliked about the game's career mode, while you see highlights of the fights that have been recorded. So we started off pretty well in the Ultimate Fighter, though I would have preferred an amateur promotion, somewhat like EA Sports MMA, just to ease us in and allow us to have a few training camps in which we hone our skills. Now the training camps are part of our problem with progression. Having an A rating in the hard version of a training drill will allow you to have the best training camp possible, if done 3 times. At the start of the game it's very difficult to get an A in the hard drills, meaning you have to settle for subpar camps. This means that you don't get the chin, stamina, body health, leg health and technique upgrades that are the prize for having a good training camp, and you're already behind in terms of your skills. Outside of career mode, if you play as a real world fighter, there are plenty of moves and skills which those guys possess to help win fights and defend in dangerous positions. With a career mode fighter, you have to buy these moves and skills with evolution points, meaning that there's a limited range of punches, kicks and submissions available in at least the first few fights. Also bought with evolution points are perks, which allow percentage upgrades to damage, stamina and other attributes. There's no way players can buy all of these or even enough to really rival the real world fighters in the game, so it's mostly a case of choosing a few moves and sticking with them. My main issue with career mode is how slowly you're made to progress up the rankings. Starting off around number 60 is pretty ridiculous. Even if the UFC have this many fighters in a division, there are many on losing streaks or recovering from health issues who you'd immediately rank above. Even with a 12 fight win streak after one loss in the UFC for 13 total fights, I was ranked around 30th. Just look at Francis Ngannou, 6 impressive UFC wins and he's got a title shot. Conor McGregor, 6 impressive wins, title shot. In the real UFC, anyone with that big of a win streak makes it up the rankings. They don't languish in the 30s and they definitely don't have legitimate contenders coming down the rankings to meet them on the undercard of fight nights. I think I speak for most gamers when I say that from a UFC game, I expect the chance to work my way up the rankings, fight big names in the top 10, and earn a title shot fairly, which I then have an actual opportunity to win. Against all opponents, Jimmy's stamina seems to be dire, draining from a few punches, transitions, or movement, despite eventually being at a 94 out of 100 rating. Similarly, Jimmy's stand-up, rated 99 by the end of this video, couldn't knock out even Bob Sapp. Fighting anyone with any sense on the ground, or even CM Punk for some reason, resulted in block transitions, easily snap submission attempts, and all manner of danger from sudden ground and pound. Being hit at all on the feet, whether body strikes or head strikes, almost immediately knocked Jimmy out, and this is from people in the 30s in the rankings. Career mode has adaptive difficulty, which means the fights get harder as time goes on. But I'm not sure how much harder they'd need to get before being literally impossible. I'm sure there's some things I don't do quite right in the game, maybe I focus too much on striking, don't block enough or whatever, but when the game is actively denying you every single thing you're attempting, and standing still will only have the same effect, there's not a lot more I can do with this career mode. I could put the game on easy, and run through the competition like a knife through hot butter, but that wouldn't be fair on me as a gamer or you as viewers. Hopefully this is something that UFC 3 is able to fix, a more realistic progression up the rankings, more interesting training camps, a look into the build-up side of fighting, promos, press conferences and other media obligations. I've had fun with UFC 2 and designing and fighting with Jimmy has been a real blast, but to be ranked 30th after 10 episodes just means that the fun is coming to an end. there's no guarantee there'd ever be a title shot, and with the career damage meter filling up ever faster, it looks like Jimmy's UFC days are coming to an end. All that remains is to give him a few last tattoos and take a look at the highlights of his career. So thanks for watching this UFC 2 Career Mode series. Sorry we didn't end up getting a title shot or anywhere close to a belt, but know that we'll be back soon and better than ever to take on the challenges of UFC 3. If you've enjoyed this series, leave a like. If you're new here in the Armbar Arcade, subscribe to keep up with the latest videos. Leave in the comments your favourite Jimmy Lights Out Rogers fights, and I'll see you next time on the Armbar Arcade.